Smart Investing.
Welcome back to Smart Investing. Well, joining me on the show tonight is Stuart Wemyss from Pro Solution Private Clients, and we've just been joined by News Corp real estate expert Tom Panos. Good to see you, Tom. Now, your rule number six is invest in the share market using low-cost passive investments. Now, I always thought before is you hire the best person you can, like a buyer's agent,
yep.
Hire the best person to sell your property as well. But it's weird, you're actually saying the opposite when it comes to shares.
Yeah, two very different strategies for property and shares, and it's based on all the research, and really all these rules are founded in really basic logic and basic math and so forth. So the research is that active fund managers or even stock pickers, so people that are investing in direct shares themselves, can't beat the market consistently over the long run. They might be able to do it for 1 or 2 years, but then the third year is terrible performance. And again, this is very extensive research. So instead of trying to pick the needle in the haystack, just invest in the haystack. Invest in a broad-based index exposure, low cost, hold it for long term, and you'll do well.
Definitely goes against property, doesn't it? Because especially in times now where you've got 50% clearance rates, you pick an average agent and they could really screw up your property, couldn't they?
Absolutely. But I mean, I can see where Stuart's coming from, because I think what you're basically doing is you're buying a lot of things and it's amortizing any risks. And it's actually following a little bit what property does. Like, you know, Chris, we buy property and you advise clients to buy property not to come in and out of it and have all the taxation implications. And what you're pretty much saying is the same thing, is that is buy shares but treat it like property. Put it in a shelf, don't sit there looking at it every night, playing the, you know, keeping score every day. You're saying, yep. You know, think like a property person in shares.
Yep.
Now, rule number seven, and I'd never heard this term before, only invest in investment-grade property. What's the difference between that and any old property?
You know, so there's a lot of conversation in the media and newspapers and so forth about property as it's just this one homogenous asset. But we all know that's not true, that there's properties that make very good investments and properties that make very bad investments. So investment-grade property, in my mind, has three fundamental characteristics. The first one is that more than 50% of the value is represented in land value. The second one is there has to be the scarcity element, scarcity in terms of architectural style, but also land location as well. So this land supply is very finite in those areas. And the last one, it's got to have proven performance so that you can go and track the past sales of that particular asset over the last 30 years. And if it's demonstrated the capacity to be able to grow at 12% per annum, for example, I don't know what the next 30 years will look like, but it's some really good evidence. So investment grade property has to have all three of those characteristics. You can't just have a couple.
Now, Tom, you would know, both speaking to your agents and also as an auctioneer, there's some properties you can sell with your eyes shut that they're going to walk out the door straight away, and there's others that you just know are going to struggle.
Yeah, and even in a bad market, those really good ones, they're still going to sell. And the ones that have got problems, sometimes even in a good market, they can still be problematic. So quality is everything.
Yep.
Now, your next tip is protect your investments from expected and unexpected risks. So how can you understand the unexpected risks?
Yeah, there's not too much, believe it or not, that happens in life that's not really that predictable. And I say that just from obviously years of experience. But I find, Chris, that most people think about return before they think about risk. But really we can sit down and think about what are all the things that can go wrong, and we need income protection insurance, we need landlord insurance, we need to have our wills up to date, we need to have a bonding financial agreement if we enter into a relationship. There's lots of things that you can do that is relatively easy to implement that mitigates a lot of your investment risk. So really that's the last rule, is just try and get rid of as much risk as possible so you're earning the highest return for the absolute lowest risk.
Now, just as a final question on the topic, how can viewers find a financial planner they can trust? Obviously, we'll give them your details in a minute. But apart from that, how can they find one?
The simple answer, Chris, is someone that's independent. If you're looking for strategic financial planning advice, which is distinct from asset class advice, because you can go out and get a good buyer's agent or so forth, but if you're before that step and you want to know what your investment strategy looks like, then really you need to deal with someone that doesn't have a vested interest in the advice outcome. So you can come to me, Chris, and I can say, put all your money in property or put it all in shares or super, or do absolutely nothing at all, and I have no commercial interest in the outcome of that advice. That's absolutely key. And then the last point is make sure they understand the key asset classes, so property and shares, and they've got, I think, personal experience, but also professional experience in both of them.
Now, I read Stuart's book literally about a week ago when I was in Bali relaxing around the pool with a beer. Definitely works well with a beer. If you go to investopoly.com.au, put in the code SKY, you'll actually give them a discount of 30%. Not that you need a discount, it's worth every single cent.
Yep.
But that's open for, I think, the next week.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, thanks very much for that. And definitely a great book. And it's one of the very, very few books that a financial planner has written that is pro-property, which is great.